Surveillance Station is capable of integrating with third-party systems via webhooks to receive event information. Event information from these external sources, such as external AI detection or access control systems, can be transmitted to Surveillance Station. External event data can be used in the following actions. Display event information in real time on Monitor Center. Save event information and play back the corresponding recordings. Send alerts to Monitor Center. In this video, we'll use AI Personal Protective Equipment PPE detection system as an example to show how to set up a webhook URL and pair selected actions. This will allow you to receive notifications in Surveillance Station when there are workers without helmets or safety vests. You will find the timestamp of each section in the video description. Before you start, ensure that you have a functioning camera. Verify that your third-party system supports outgoing webhooks. Confirm that your Surveillance Station version is 9.1.4 or above. Go to Action Rule and click Add to create a rule. On the Information page, give the Action Rule a name and set the rule type as triggered. Triggered rules are executed when the set event conditions are met. Scheduled rules are executed according to a timetable. Click Next. On the event page, set the event source as webhook. Create a token for the webhook. You can use the automatically generated one or configure one manually. The tokens in both the third-party system and Surveillance Station must match to establish a connection. The trigger type can be one time or interval. Choose one time for events that only the start time matters, or interval for continuous events with an end time. In this example, we will use the one time trigger type to set up this action rule. You can click on Advanced Webhook Ingredients to check supported ingredients. For example, you can use Text 1 to record event details, such as no helmet or no safety vest. And use Text 2 to record the event source as PPE detection system. Time can be used to record the event time. An accurate event time can prevent data transmission latency between systems. Copy the webhook URL that will be used to configure the external PPE detection system. After creating the webhook URL, you have the option of pairing it with actions. To display the event information in real time and store it for easier playback, pair the event with the Add Bookmark action. To send alerts to Monitor Center, select the Display an Alert in Monitor Center action. Click OK. Finish configuring the Add Bookmark action by pairing a camera with it and specifying a bookmark length. Use the Add Ingredient button to customize the bookmark name and description fields. For example, use Text 1 as the bookmark name, which can be replaced with No Helmet or No Safety Vest. Use Text 2 as the bookmark description, which can be replaced with PPE Detection System, to record the event source. Don't forget to enable Display Bookmark Information in Monitor Center if you want to see external event information pop up in real time. Finish configuring the Display Webhook Alert in Monitor Center action by pairing a camera with it and specifying how long to display the alert in Monitor Center. You can set trigger conditions to ensure the alert is triggered when the webhook data contain a specific value. If needed, you can pair more actions with the webhook event. On the Schedule page, you can set up when the action rule will be executed. Click Done to complete the setup of your new action rule. Now that the webhook URL is active, proceed to configure the PPE detection system to send a webhook URL with this specific token when a person is detected without a safety helmet or a safety vest at the construction site. Once surveillance station receives this webhook, it will create bookmarks on the paired cameras, display real-time information in monitor center, and trigger an alert. In the recording app, you can easily search for specific events and play back the corresponding recordings. To learn more about Surveillance Station, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel, or click on another video to keep watching.